Hi everyone, and welcome back to Creative PowerPoint. Today, we'll make stinger transitions between PowerPoint slides. We'll also show how to make stinger transitions with both slides visible at the same time. Let's learn how to make those transitions and customize them with your own logo. Let's start with the basic principle. I've got this slide deck, and I'd like to add simple stinger transitions. Let's add a new slide between slide 1 and 2. This slide will contain the transition animation. Let's add some shapes. Those are just squares that I've rotated. To choose harmonious colors, I went to Adobe Color and created a color palette. Let's group the squares and move the group to the left of the slide. Let's make a copy of the group and move the copy to the right of the slide. Let's add a flying animation to the left shape, starting from right. Let's also add a flying animation to the right shape, this time starting from left. Make sure both animations start at the same time and last 2 seconds. Let's go to this transition tab and make sure the slide moves to the next one after this animation. Untick on mouse click and tick after 0 seconds. Let's play the animation. As you can see, we have a blank background during the animation. Let's fix this. To do so, we'll make a creative use of the zoom tool. I've made videos earlier to explain how the zoom tool works, but here we won't use it to zoom, but just to display the previous and next slides. Go to the Insert ribbon, select Zoom, Slide Zoom, and select the next slide. You can see that PowerPoint has inserted an image of the next slide. Let's resize it to fit the screen. Hold the Ctrl key while resizing to retain the object center. Let's insert and position another zoom, but this time for the previous slide. Let's also resize it. Let's select the zoom objects and move them to the back. Let's select the next slide zoom and add a disappear animation with a delay of 1 second. Let's see how the animation works. Here's the slide initially, where we only see the previous slide zoom. Then the shapes move. The shapes fully hide the slide content. The previous slide zoom disappears, only leaving the next slide zoom. At this stage, it's still hidden by the shapes. Then, the shapes go away, revealing the next slide zoom. The benefit of this method is that you can change the content of the previous and next slides, and the transition slide will be updated automatically. The simple stinger animation is complete, but I like to do something to better manage my slides. As you can see, the thumbnail for the transition is the same as the previous slide thumbnail, which can be confusing. Let's add a text box to ensure we clearly see which slide is holding the transition. The thumbnail is much clearer now, but we don't want this text to appear during the animation. Let's just add a transparency animation to it, make it start at the beginning, and set a transparency value of 100%. For the PowerPoint logo animation, we are using the same principle with slightly different animations. Initially, we see the previous slide zoom, then the PowerPoint logo flies in, we add a grow and a spin animation. When the PowerPoint logo covers the full slide, we make the previous slide zoom disappear. Then, the PowerPoint logo goes back to its initial dimensions, revealing the new slide zoom, and we make the logo disappear with a spinner. Now, let's see how we made the transition with the 2 slides showing at the same time. By the way, this plain animation appears in the opening scene of the movie Catch Me If You Can. As previously, let's add a blank slide. Let's insert a plain icon from Microsoft Stock. Convert it to shape. Format it. and position it at the top of our slide. Let's add a fly-in animation from bottom. Let's insert a zoom to the next slide and, as previously, position it to cover the screen. Likewise, let's insert a zoom to the previous slide. Let's insert another zoom to the previous slide again. Let's open the selection pane. Let's move the plane to the foreground. Let's select one of the previous slide zoom and add a strips exit effect. By default, it will be left down, leave it as it is. Let's select the other previous slide zoom and also add a strips exit effect. This time, select right down. The timing is not obvious, but I did the math for you.
You're welcome.
Here are the timings. Initially, we see the previous slide zoom. The plane flies to the top, and the two slide zooms strip at the same time, leaving exposed the next slide zoom. Let's see the final result.
Today in BBC News, we're interviewing the zoom tool in PowerPoint.
When I was young, people used me to zoom on slides, and making zooms was a lot of fun. Those days are gone.